But if you're flying from 180 to 0 degrees in this direction, your flight levels will be even. For example, flight level 600, I mean 6,000 feet. Okay, that means I'll tell you what is a transition level and all. So these are like IFR rules. VFR, you know, correct? You have to maintain so many so much distance from the cloud. Vertically, you have to maintain so many feet from the cloud. We will learn it tomorrow in next class, IFR and VFR rules. But any aircraft, whether in flight, on the ground, in the taxiway, taking off, other than this IFR and VFR rules, it has to follow some rules called as general rules. Clear? During the operation of an aircraft at all times, that is whether the aircraft is on ground or in flight, it has to follow general rules. In addition to general rules, if you are flying visual, you will follow visual flight rules, VFR rules. If you are flying instrument, you will follow IFR rules. Am I clear? So general rules is something that every aircraft, no matter what it is, it has to follow. Am I clear? No. This is a question. To what do the ICAO rules of air annex 2 apply in general? It will apply to all aircrafts. So it will to all IFR topic? No. IFR plus VFR. So individual will not be correct. To all aircraft registered in the state being awful? No. Any aircraft in any country, it should follow these general rules. If there is a difference between the country and the ICAO, it can notify to ICAO. But general rules to be followed by all aircrafts. Am I clear? But today, I'll complete the general rules. Today, we will see all the general rules. Am I making sense? Correct? Next. See, what is the role of pilot in command in an aircraft? For example, two guys are flying.
Okay.
Now, this is the cockpit. Captain went to washroom.
Correct.
Now, what first officer did? He did a aerobatic kind of maneuver.
Correct.
For example, he banked the aircraft to say 45 degrees, an airliner. Correct. Now, after coming down to the airline and to the DGCA, who has to give the explanation why this happened? Is it the first officer will be blamed or is it the captain? Captain is in bathroom. Captain? The first officer did. Amok, I am the captain, you are the first officer. Who should give the explanation?
Sir, whatever I do, you have to be it is your responsibility. Correct. Even if I crash something, it is your responsibility.
Very good. So, for example, if a student and an instructor are flying, correct, and by mistake, a student landed very hard and aircraft landing gear broke, student will not be held responsible. It is the instructor who is flying with him should have said ki my aircraft, and he should have controlled the or he should have controlled the rate of descent and should have landed safely. Am I clear? Always the pilot in command is the in charge. Whether he is at the controls, manipulating the controls, not at the controls, he is in the bathroom, he is flirting with the cabin crew. Okay. Amok, don't do that. Understood? So the thing is, PIC is always responsible. Always. Okay. Now we'll just see through the lines which are mentioned in ICAO. What is the responsibility of the PAC? So he will have final authority of the aircraft. He is the one who will decide how much is the fuel. He is the one who will decide if they need extra fuel. He is the one who can say, today I'm not taking off because the weather is not good. So disposition of the aircraft, whether to fly or not, whether to land or not, he is the final authority of the aircraft. Okay. So PAC shall have the final authority as to disposition of the aircraft. What to do with the aircraft, he will decide. PAC, whether at the controls or not, he will be responsible for the operation of the aircraft. Before a flight begins, he is responsible that he have to collect all the weather, all the no times. Correct. See, he cannot say, I have told my first officer to collect the no times. He did not collect. I don't know. No. He has to check personally. Okay. So all the fuel requirements, all the weather forecast, if something goes wrong, what would be the alternate course of action? Even before the beginning of the flight, PAC should become very familiar with all the information available. Am I clear? She should become very familiar with all the information available. Am I clear? Next. For example, an aircraft is flying from let's say Delhi to Mumbai. His alternate aerodrome is Jaipur. Okay. Now, imagine Agra has a runway. Okay. Now, for example, a pilot or a passenger develops a heart attack mid-flight. Okay. And that pilot is not a doctor like me. Correct. So he wants to land at the closest possible airport. If you are on waterway, like how do you go about this situation? What is the topic in navigation?
CP, PNR.
In CP and PNR, which will you choose? What is critical time, critical point?
CP.
Point, the time will be the least, correct? Before you cross. And after you cross, you will go to destination. I mean, if you don't have alternate or any other thing. So the decision to land, because he has not decided, he is not filed in the flight plan. Can he do this? For example, an engine failed. Can he do that? Can he land in the Agra? Yes, correct. He can depart from any dam rule in case if that action would be needed for the safety of the aircraft. Am I clear? So he has to follow all rules, but when it comes to safety, safety first, then rules. Correct. So PAC may depart from all these rules in circumstances that render such departure is absolutely necessary in terms of safety. Okay. So you cannot land and say, here I felt it is safe to land in Agra. No. You cannot say, I want to see Taj Mahal, so I landed. It is important. No. It should be absolutely necessary for the safety of the aircraft. There is an engine failure. You may think that there is a lot of headwinds to go to Jaipur. So you have landed in Agra. That is okay. Okay. Here, you are flying the aircraft. You are preparing the aircraft. Okay. Now, all the passengers are seated in the aircraft. Correct, in this aircraft. For example, this aircraft met CAT, clear air turbulence, flying from Delhi to Kolkata with Jetstream Metrol Insurance. Which Jetstream Delhi to Kolkata? Subtropical.
Subtropical
westerly jet stream. Okay. So you met SCAT, and then there was severe turbulence. Now, few passengers got severely hurt because even though seatbelt sign was on, these two passengers did not put the seatbelt signs from the start. Even before the aircraft took off, they did not put the seatbelt sign. Now, will the head of the cabin crew will be answerable, or the PIC in command will be answerable for this thing? Who is to be blamed? That one of the passengers had a cervical fracture and he is in ICU, and your airline is paying the fee, paying for the treatment. Now, who will be held responsible? Are you or the cabin crew?
Pilot in command.
Pilot in command.
Here, why here? Will you go and check your passenger seat belt lage? Will you check? How many times you have seen?
No one will be responsible.
No. Pilot in command should be responsible. Okay. So he has to confirm before every flight that all passengers are seated and seat belts are on. If not, he is at a stage key, he can say, I'll not take off with all passengers with seatbelts. Correct. When it comes to safety, pilot in command. Commander of a public transport aircraft, like for example Indigo, must ensure that passenger seatbelts are secure for takeoff, landing, taxiing, turbulence, and during emergencies. It is his responsibility. Okay. Am I clear? With this small idea about these things, we'll go to general rules. General rules means which aircraft have to follow this?
Which aircraft? All aircrafts.
All aircrafts, correct. Give me a second. Okay. There are many general rules. Okay. So we will complete the class after completing general rules only today. Okay. Very simple, very easy, very understandable, and you will also love it. First thing is protection of persons and property. Okay. You should never operate an aircraft in a negligent or reckless manner so as to endanger life or property of others. Nothing but don't do overreaction in the cockpit. Okay, be careful. It is not only you. If something happens, if something goes wrong, it is the others who are on land might get hurt. Someone would have built his house working all his life, and you can go and damage it if you do some thing stupid, correct? So don't fly in a negligent and reckless manner so as to cause any damage to life or property of others. Clear? Now, see, for example, if this is the city, these are the buildings, there is your runway. Never come close to the city, close to congested areas, unless you are coming in for landing or you are taking off. Clear? For example, you may say, sir, how is this possible? Correct? See, this is where I live. Should load up here. This is Begumpet Airport. Correct. Now see. If this is the Begumpet Airport, okay, so how you do the traffic pattern? You do the traffic pattern like this. You, okay. You take off. You take a left turn. Again left. Again left. And you come and land. Okay, generally this will be actually very big like this, but I'm showing just to show all the turns in a traffic pattern are generally left turns only. Okay, for example, if you're flying this runway here also, you will turn left, 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 and land like this. Am I clear? Now you're flying this traffic pattern. Okay. See, anywhere in the circuit, if you lose your engine, correct? Circuit pattern is only 1,000 feet. Correct. You should not go and crash into this city. Do you see any place where to go and land in this scenario? No, correct. So you should be able to come and land here. Okay. So that means if you're maintaining only 1,000 feet, you will maintain this 1,000 feet only in circuit pattern. Now you may say, sir, this part, na, I will use this for sector flying. Sector flying. Now, how to go about this? Correct. See, in sectors, you will be allotted levels. Correct. Sector flying is nothing but you take off, you enter a sector and you keep roaming so that your hours will increase. You practice turns, steep turns. Correct. You practice stalls in it. This is sector flying. Now, in this kind of flying also, you will be given, for example, 4,000. Even if you are flying single engine and your engine fails at 4,000 feet, at least the distance should be, you have to be able to glide and come and land on the runway. Clear? So when you are flying over congested cities, correct? If something goes wrong, you should be able to come and land near the runway. So don't come down for any other reasons except for takeoff and landing. Does this make sense? Okay. So, except when necessary for takeoff and landing, aircraft shall not be flown over congested areas or cities. Okay. Towns or settlements or over open air assembly of persons unless such height will permit. In the event of emergency, you will be landing without undue hazard to the persons or property. Am I clear? That is about the minimum height at which you can fly. Next is cruising levels. Here, we will learn regarding these cruising levels in detail in instrument navigation. Okay. Or if you have come for pressure classes, here guys, you're turning off your cameras. Why? Kaustav is okay. He's outside. See.
Sorry, sir. I got called.
No problem. Lucky. Don't say sorry. Okay. I will never shout. I'll not do anything. If student is not turning on the camera, student is at loss, na? Understood. at peace, you enjoy life. Next. Yeah, you really turned off. What is this, yeah, lucky? Turn on, no? Keep it on. Keep it on.
Okay. Sir, I got call, sir.
Okay, when the call comes, the phone is. Understand, I understood.
Yeah, sir.
Okay, fine. See, cruising levels. Generally, when you fly from one, as a student pilot, for example, you're going on a cross country, correct? You are more concerned about if there are hills in between. For example, you go from Begumpet to Srisailam, correct? Or Kurnool. These are in 100 nautical miles distance, correct? So there are hills in between, correct? Srisailam is a forest area. So on map, you see the height of a hill in Srisailam, correct? Let's say it's elevation. We call it as elevation. If it is says that this is Hyderabad, let's say this is Hyderabad, this is Srisailam. For example, if this says in the map like this, and if it says 4,000 feet, that means the elevation of this hill is 4,000 feet. Am I clear? By definition, elevation means from mean sea level. That means if you're flying, there is a hill in this place, that from the mean sea level, not from the ground. Ground is like this. This is ground. Okay. From the mean sea level, the height is 4,000 feet. So on your altimeter, you set, what do you set? QNH. So in QNH, from where do you measure? You measure your height from mean sea level, correct? And you call this as what? Altitude. So QNH is equals to altitude. Am I clear? Now see, in India, except Himalayas, there is no elevation which is beyond 5,000 or 6,000 feet. Generally in India, there is something called as transition level, again, which we will see in instruments. I'm just giving an idea. So below this, there is a problem of terrain. Correct? Above this, there is no problem of terrain. For example, one guy took off from Hyderabad. Let's say QNH is today 1012. From Srisailam, if another aircraft took off with a QNH of 1010, let's say, see, between Hyderabad and Srisailam, there is no airport. Correct? That means they are flying at different altitudes. Okay, understood. One is flying at 3,000, one is flying at 4,000, but they are measuring their levels from different datums, correct? Understand? So what they do, they climb beyond the transition level and everyone will maintain 1013. Okay, so when they come close like this, this guy will be going at, let's say 5,000 feet. So he is maintaining 1013. That means from, let's say if this is 1013, so from here it is 1013. Okay. So this guy, when coming, he will be maintaining 6,000 feet from 1013. Am I clear? So this is called as QNE, also called as flight levels. So above this transition layer, correct, you will not call 5,000 feet. You will call flight level 50. Understood? So above transition level, it's all flight levels. Below transition levels, it's all altitudes. Do you understand the definitions? Definitions in the sense, the correct understanding. Altitude means you are measuring from the mean sea level. Okay. Flight levels means you are measuring from the 1013 data. Am I clear? We will learn in detail about transition layer again in instruments. Okay. We have a lot of problems and all. We'll do it. numericals. How many of you understood? Raise your hands. Clear. So I'll take that it is understood. Okay. If not, no worries. In detail, we will be reading somewhere else. Cruising levels. So flight levels at or above the lowest usable flight level. That means, see, this is flight level 50, correct? Flight level 60, flight level 70. So what is the highest level anyone, any aircraft can fly in India? I mean, civil aircrafts. Anyone guess?
6,000 feet.
Huh?
Highest flight level.
Flight level anyone can fly in India.
36,000 feet.
36.
Options A, 36,000 feet. B, 39,000 feet. C, 43,000 feet. D, 46,000 feet. E, flight level 360. F, flight level 380.
Option C, sir.
Huh? Wait, MG. Flight level 430. H, flight level 460. Answer, please.
Sir, option 3.
Option?
3.
Option C, by lucky. Okay, kaun banega karorpati?
Sir, option E.
Option E by Kaustav.
Option E, sir.
Option E by Ramakant.
E, sir.
Echo. A and E are same, sir.
The answer is flight level 460. You can fly your aircraft till flight level 460 if your aircraft can fly till there. Okay. Believe me. I mean, you will not go to that level. Like if you're flying a, let's say,
747
Concorde or something, it will go.
Sir, 747 can, right? At least above flight level.
I'm not like in performance. Again, we will discuss about ceiling, aircraft ceiling, aircraft service ceiling. Correct. There, I'll discuss how it is. Like, what are the factors which cause the ceiling? Correct. Beyond this, why aircrafts will not go. But generally, India, you cannot fly beyond 46,000 feet is not the correct answer. See, there are 46,000 feet and flight level 460. Because if you're flying at flight level 460, you are flying above the transition layer, correct? Where the levels are only in flight levels. Okay. So this is, I gave in altitude. So these all are definitely wrong. So you have to choose from these. And it is flight level 460. Am I clear? The difference between altitudes and flight levels. Lucky?
Yes.
So, the highest usable flight level in India is flight level 460. Okay. So this will be done in instruments. Detailed explanation. Okay. Of course, we are starting next week instruments, correct? So 1 week. See, as per aircraft rules 1937, nothing can be dropped or sprayed from the aircraft in flight except under conditions prescribed. So and so. Okay, so you, for example, you carried a Coke bottle. Okay, sometimes people carry food for cross countries because 3 hours you have to sit idle. You can eat chips. Correct. Sometimes you get hungry. Correct. Sometimes you might not have had breakfast in a hurry preparing your cross country sheet. So you can carry, but don't throw anything out. Correct. Am I clear? If that Coke bottle or it comes down, it comes with a very high velocity. Believe me, if it hits someone on the head, he's dead. And it will come like a bullet. Am I clear? Here, towing of an aircraft is not at all permitted in India. Not at all. See, no aircraft or other object shall be towed by an aircraft except if there is a proper permission. But in India, they will not give permission. A towing of an aircraft is not permitted in India. Okay. Or towing of any other object is also not permitted. For example, you see in US, they will be flying and they will carry banners, correct? For advertisement.
Yes,
on the beach, correct? That kind of things are not permitted in India. In India, how many times you have seen a Cessna carrying a banner? Never. Am I clear? Clear. See, parachute descents are generally not allowed. Correct? You cannot go on a cross country taking a parachute and jump out of the aircraft. You cannot say my instructor will fly the aircraft. Okay. So you cannot do that unless, for example, there are flying clubs where they do aerobatics, correct? They take passengers, they train them, and then they take to higher altitudes and jump with a parachute, and then they open the parachutes, correct? So that can be done with proper permission from the authorities, correct? See, and as indicated by relevant information, advice, or clearance from the appropriate air traffic services unit, and in accordance, this is nothing but you should take permission from DGCA. So wherever there is this kind of boring regular thing, I've changed the font so that you need not, you by seeing that font you will understand from appropriate authority I will take this. This is what you have to read. That's all. Okay, you need not read this other font. Am I clear? So it will decrease your time of reading. You can read this chapter under 10 minutes after this class. Am I clear? Next. Here, aerobatic flight. Put a star mark. Please. Cooperate. Aerobatic flight, star mark. Amuk, can you take your aircraft? Go to a sector. Nobody is watching you. Your transponder is not working, for example. Now, can you do aerobatics? I mean, can you do inverted flight? You know how to do it. Okay. You know how to do it. Can you do it? Or will you do it? You know how to do it. Nobody is watching you. Will you do it? Here, I don't have time here.
I can try, sir.
You can try. Here, what am I teaching? I am teaching rules of air, and in this lesson, you are telling you will do aerobatic flight without proper permissions. Do you see? Do you see this? It's prescribed by the appropriate authority as indicated by the relevant information. Okay. For example, you do an aerobatic maneuver. Okay. So in that aerobatic maneuver, you are cleared for 5,000 feet altitude. Correct. There is an aircraft at 4,000 feet altitude, which you don't know because ATC will know. Correct. You did not listen on the radio and you did aerobatics. That aerobatic will lead to loss. For example, you banged 70 degrees bank. Of course, there will be loss of lift. Of course, the aircraft will lose height. Correct. And you think that you know how to do it, but you don't know. Understood? Understood. I have not taught you yet. Na? How will you know? Clear? So never do. Unless.
Okay, sir.
And these air shows will happen in Bangalore. Correct. So they will have proper in written permission from DGC. Okay. So never attempt any aerobatic maneuver while flying all your life unless there is in written permission from DGC. Correct. Now, when you have in written permission from DGC, let's say you became a very good pilot and Red Bull hired you, okay, to do their air shows. Right? These Red Bull guys will be flying, doing aerobatics. Now, in that case, what you will do here, all aerobatic maneuvers should be completed. For example, you're doing a barrel roll or something, correct? I mean, it will be like this here. It will come like this and it will go. Correct. That should be done. I mean, if this is the ground, that maneuver should be over that maneuver should be over. You cannot come below this level. That is 2000 feet. You cannot come below 2000 feet. Here in India, we measure height in feet. But there are some countries which measure height in meters also. Correct. So IKOF has given 2000 feet or 600 meters. Okay. In exams, DGCA guys might ask in the options in meters because they just would have copied that line from the IKOF rules. Correct. So remember 2000 feet or 600 meters. Am I clear? Your aerobatic maneuver should complete like this. Now, if you are flying close to an aerodrome, for example, let's say this is an aerodrome. I wrote in the shape of A to say this is an aerodrome. Correct. If you are flying close to an aerodrome, correct, you cannot come below 6,000 feet. Unless you are at least 2 nautical miles away from the airport. This is from the perimeter of the airport, you are at least 2 nautical miles. From the perimeter of the aircraft airport, you are at least 2 nautical miles. So you cannot come flying aerobatically close to the aerodrome this much. Okay. You can complete here. Aerobatics, understood. Beyond 2 nautical miles, you can come close, but from the first rule, you cannot come below 2000 feet or 600 meters. Am I clear? 6,000 feet or 1800 meters. Correct. In this cone, you cannot fly. Am I clear? No need to draw anything. You can just listen to the class. If you want to write, you can write down. I have no issues. But I'll be sharing this PDF with you. Okay. No aircraft can fly aerobatically except under conditions. Okay, fine. When aircraft is used for aerobatics, correct? Completion of maneuver should be at a height of 2000 feet or 600 meters. Correct? I mean, if, for example, you are flying an aircraft, which will say if you are doing aerobatics, you should complete at 3000 feet, then 3000 feet. Generally, not below 2000 feet. Okay, next. It shall be flown by a pilot licensed, who is licensed to fly aerobatics as aerobatic pilot. Correct. If someone is flying for qualifying purpose of to get a license, correct, then there should be accompanied by a licensed instructor also. You cannot say, here I am flying aerobatically solo. Correct. You will be accompanied by a licensed instructor. If something you make wrong, he will take over and correct it. He will semi aircraft. You leave all the controls. It will be his controls. Am I clear? Yes. For example, you're flying from, let's say, Delhi to Kolkata. For example, you are flying for IndiGo. IndiGo took an aircraft for as a rent, okay, as a lease, okay, a dry lease from, let's say, from America, some other airline. Okay, now IndiGo wants to give back this aircraft. When those guys comes, they will ask, here, fly this aircraft and show us. They will ask. Okay. They will have to check whether if something goes wrong, is the aircraft correcting itself or not. Okay. Then these IndiGo guys will notify if, for example, there are 5 or 10 passengers on this aircraft. Let's say this is an ATR. That day it has only 10 passengers. So it says ki your mid flight between Delhi and let's say Kolkata, let's say Mumbai, Kolkata is not here, no? Mumbai. we will be conducting maneuvers where we will stall the aircraft and we want to check the autopilot whether it corrects itself or not. That's how we will, they will come to know whether the automated systems are working or not. Correct. Then they have to make all the passengers sign that they are going to sit in an aircraft which is going to be stalled. Okay. So this used to happen long back, and there was an incident, the exact thing which I said happened, and the pilot started stall very close to the ground. He thought that anyway the autopilot will take over. Autopilot did not take over. His stall could not be recovered before it hit the ground, and everyone in the aircraft died. You can see this documentary on the YouTube also. Am I clear? So if you're conducting aerobatics with passengers, okay, you should obtain in writing their consent. Am I clear on this? And of course, PIC shall satisfy himself that everyone has proper seat belts before starting any aerobatic maneuver, or even before moving the aircraft, even before taxiing the aircraft. Am I clear? So in your flying club, you cannot fly aerobatically. You may cause hazard to the other air traffic. Like I told, among you are flying at 5,000 feet, at 4,000 feet, if there is an aircraft. Okay. So you cannot fly aerobatically.
Sir, every aircraft can maneuver.
Every aircraft?
Can maneuver.
No, not every aircraft. I think in India, there is one Cessna, which is Cessna 152, which is aerobatically approved. So what is meant by aerobatic approval is, we have something called as load factor. Load factor, Ramakant, what is load factor?
Lift by weight, sir.
Lift by weight, very good. Correct. That means the lift, generally every aircraft, okay, which flies will fly because it produces a lift. Understood? This is lift and this is weight. Okay. But now, for example, if an aircraft is like this, attempting to do a vertical climb. Now, the wings are like this to the aircraft. That means lift is generated in this direction. Correct? Lift is always generated perpendicular to the wings. If this is my wing, lift is generated like this, correct? If these are my wings. So the whole thrust of the aircraft is balancing the weight. Clear? Clear. But no aircraft, which is like most of the aircrafts, are not aerobatically approved. That means your thrust will be less than weight. You are flying because your thrust is balancing the drag, and your weight is balanced by the airflow on the wing and below the wing, that is lift. Clear? Your engine doesn't have the power to carry the weight of your aircraft. So if an aircraft is said to be aerobatically approved, its engine should produce so much thrust that it will balance out its weight. That means it can do, if this is the runway, normally an aircraft will do like this climb, correct? If an aircraft is aerobatically approved, generally it can just go forward and do a vertical takeoff, like how the fighter jets do. Correct. So that is aircraft maneuverability. Generally, all Cessnas which you fly in India doesn't have it. I heard that there is only one Cessna in India which is aerobatically approved. If I am not wrong, it is with Bombay Flying Club. I don't know. Okay, this is just a hearsay. Clear? You understand now, Manthan, what is meant by aerobatic approval or capability? Did you really understand?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Very good. I mean, all this we will see in detail in technical general. Lift, drag, thrust, correct, weight, which balances what in a flight. Next. So no person shall fly aerobatically within 2 nautical miles from the nearest point of the perimeter of the aerodrome unless he is at a height of 6,000 feet. Clear? That means you should complete your maneuver above 6,000 feet. If you are within 2 nautical miles, if you are beyond 2 nautical miles from an aerodrome, you can come close to the ground, but up before only minimum is 2,000 feet. Correct? These are the two rules. How many of you really understood and it is all clear? Raise your hands. Very good. Lucky? Very good. Now, you may ask, sir, you conducted air shows in Bangalore. Correct? Is it not a popular city? How can you do it? See, they follow these two rules. Correct? And they have an approval letter from DGCA. Okay. See, DGCA is a very, kind of board which is very strict with these kind of things. Correct. There are some airlines like SpiceJet. They don't really understand the importance of flying. They don't understand how an aircraft flies, and they are an airline. This is what I strongly believe. Okay. See, I'll tell you one good example. Okay. They recently, like two scenarios I'll tell you. One scenario for a Diwali, okay, what they did was for Diwali or Holi, okay, they made all air hostess dance in the mid-flight. Then what happened? All passengers came out and started dancing. And then what happened? See, first officer or captain came out, took a selfie, posted it on Facebook or Instagram, social media. Now everybody came to know this has happened. See, I'll tell you, an aircraft is maintaining It's like aircraft is in air. For example, this aircraft weight is 136,000 tons. Correct. It is maintaining its weight like a seesaw from the center of gravity. And now it has wings that they're maintaining lift from center of pressure. Correct. And this tail plane delicately balancing them. Correct. You are at the controls balancing delicately. Now, suddenly if 10 people move forward, that means you have to pull the stick so far, so hard, so that your nose won't go down. Am I clear? Are these not aerobatics? Correct. So don't do these kind of stupid things. Not. If you are a captain, even in SpiceJet, you say, okay, today I'm going on sick leave. Okay. I'm having loose motions. Okay, you tell them, okay. Now these SpiceJet, though, okay, fine. Those captain who flew the aircraft that day and the pilot who took the selfie, correct? That was there. Like he posted here, this kind of thing. And of course they are like given some kind of punishment. Correct? I think they were suspended for 1 year or so. Something like that have happened. Recently also these stupid guys again conducted one marriage mid-flight. Okay, here, see, someone who is very rich wants to conduct marriage in mid-flight. You book the aircraft. I understand. Na? But you book a private jet in which there are only 10 people, but the engines are so powerful that it will not be a problem. Not an airliner here. Airliner, they give you a seat. That means you have to sit in that seat.